I'm Adrian Seymour, and I'm helping the senior scientist for Operation Wallacea here in Kosuko National Park. Kosuko National Park is up on the north west coast of Honduras, and it's one of the few cloud forest reserves that they have spread around the whole country. It's special because it's got this cloud forest habitat, this habitat that you see behind me, which is one of the rarest types of tropical rainforests in the world, rapidly decreasing. So we're interested in seeing what's up in these forests and trying to find a way to ensure their continued survival. Diversity here is very special. I still think I got a little situation. So listen to me, sister, listen, maybe you can help. I think I give a lot of fathers my consideration, but not for me, it always seemed to be for someone else. Well, all the people always seem to just be on vacation. What do I get from it? I don't get anything at all. I'm like a trash can holding all the information, and every single time I need me feeling to be tall. Operation Wallacea has several aims. The first one is to provide kind of an inventory of the species in an area. So for the last, I think since 2004 or 2005, Operation Wallacea has been working in this park to find out exactly what species are existing here. And in doing so, Operation Wallacea has not only made a list of the species, but also discovered some new ones that we didn't know were here, or hadn't been expected. Number two, the next thing that Operation Wallacea does is provide the basis for a long-term survey. And this is something that most research councils and other funding bodies won't do. They barely fund anything more than a few years. But Operation Wallacea is here for the long term, which means we can get these wonderful long-term data sets that are so rare in ecology. Number three, finally, is we use the information that we get to bring in funds from outside and actually start up real conservation programs in order to save the biodiversity that we've been listing here. The benefit of students here is twofold. Firstly, without the student involvement, there would be no project. It's you guys that allow the independent funding. Number two, we have so much data to collect that it's so labor intensive that we wouldn't be able to collect it without the help of students. It would be impossible. So we have a whole variety of data to collect. Most of it requires stomping around through the jungle and measuring things and counting things and catching things. it requires immense amounts of effort, and it would be impossible to do that with just the scientists by themselves.